not to full capacity. They have a little issue I need to work on. And it's also a single action bellow, so I don't get as much pump as I.
We're going to do one practice, and so do not. Charge your piece. Prime your piece. Shut your pan. Cast off the cords. Cast about your piece. Charge your piece. And bring up your piece. Cock your match. Draw your match while guarding your pan.
We're not going to fire this time, so don't worry about your ears.
Present your piece, open your pan, and give fire! Bang!
Bang!
Good job,
that.
Bring down your piece. Shoulder your piece. Now, once again, there are about 43 commands for some of the musketry. With men without forquettes or musket rest, there was only about 30-some, and we're going to try to go through some of them once again as we get ready. This time we will be firing, and we shut your pan, cast off loose corns, blow off loose corns, cast about your piece, charge your piece, draw your match and guard your pan, present your piece.
Protected us against about 35,000 Native Americans who lived all around here. And that was just mainly from here to the falls. We don't really know what was beyond the falls because most Englishmen have never ventured past there, perhaps past that place called Richmond now. So basically, these muskets and these men were facing men out front, usually called targeteers with armor, to guard them like a wall as they marched forward. Usually, as they were loading, there would be a man out front called a targeteer making a wall of steel like this, usually wearing a helmet and armor, so that they could be protected while they were actually reloading or while they were in the field. Otherwise, the natives were some of the finest warriors in the world. Without our weapons and armor, we would have been simply cast back into the sea. I'm going to have these men, are you going to fire again? All right, gentlemen, make ready. I have many ranks of these men, and if I can fire twice a minute, then I can keep up a line of fire as the natives are approaching, because as they get in close with their arrows, they are very deadly, and we cannot stop them.
Present! Present! And give fire! Misfire! Uncock your mask.
By having this on you on hand at all, it's because he is free.
I was just trying to be a little.
You were being nice. You were being nice. You're one of those musketeers.
These palisaded walls, but we could not live in here. We would have to go out for fight. As a matter of fact, there was a period. What was it called? The feed fights.
Something like that.
The feed fights, and we would actually go out raiding villages.
Fermented urine.
Fermented urine. Was it sheep urine or just
people urine? People
oh
urine.
Goodness.
We weren't allowed to raise sheep.
Okay. No, but we don't use that anymore. Until they were coming, but they didn't know which village they were going to that day. And the natives were not able to move their food stores and other things out of the way. So how part of the early... Once again, these gentlemen, if you'd like to ask questions about the different equipment that they wear or their muskets, because once again, these were the most modern weapons in the world, especially this big bruiser right here.
Given to club your piece. And we go at them like this. However, the Powhatan warriors have been training since the age of 6 or more or less our best bet is to fire as quickly as possible and resort to our butts, as they call them, as rarely as possible. The other command is not just club your piece, but to show them your butts.
Now, this was much more effective in Europe when between European armies, but not, as he'd said, very effective on the natives, because they might not wait until you swung the musket at them before they put several arrows into your chest. So it was different here. The tactics that we used in England and Europe...
100 yards, however, about the first 100 yards is your accuracy range. Okay. Powhatan Indians can shoot you in the eye from 50 yards away. But that's about the maximum range. The accuracy around us would not have been here.
Yeah. Okay.
They're all chopped down.
Around
we're up in that tower.
Right, around the settlement would be, but as you're going...
Well, you're always lit and always loaded, first of all, so you can get that first shot off. And one of the things they're going to do is not just stand and shoot willy-nilly. They're going to stand in formation, and they're going to fire in sequence. Picture 25... No, 300 was our total complement here at the fort.
Okay.
Smaller groups are going to go out from time to time. We have scouts, we have towers. We're not going to go so far away from the fort that we're in danger all the time. And also, don't keep in mind that we are not always at war with the Powhatan Nation. We also trade with them for food. As Dennis mentioned, yes, sometimes there will be raiding parties. That's more of a guarantee that you're going to come back alive. It's a real risky business, definitely.
What kind of compliment are the Indians, typical group of Indians coming in?
You can't say what would be typical. There are 30
these muskets as their only defense.
And to address the rest of your question, we are not allowed in 1611 and in the first several decades of the settlement, we are not allowed to make their production of wool control. Mostly they control all of Europe's wool supply. So they don't want to let us do that. So making things, we're not going to do it. You can hear the blacksmith.
Some musket firing. We are going to be doing some black powder, so just give you a heads up. If you got hearing aids or any small ones, might be sensitive to gunfire. So once you're all gathered around, feel free to come under the shade tree. There's some benches here that we'll make sure we'll clear off for you. And knock yourselves out, but we're going to take one more.
St. George, the same flag that has graced many a battles across all of Europe. But however, here in the New World, we have a much, much different adversary. The Native Americans that live in this land long before we came are very athletic and they're very apt warriors. They can fire arrows like this from as far as 50 yards away and hit a man dead in the eye.
Oh my.
This one's not heavy enough for a musket rest or a forquette, so it only has about 30 commands, but I don't ever count them. Musketeer. So these were brought out, and we brought them to the New World, and basically what we do is when we are fighting, these musketeers will be behind a wall of targeteers like this, usually carrying a sword, or in this case, a fine weapon like this cutlass. We would have to carry our weapons and our baggage. Our baggies would contain perhaps a dry pair of socks.
Found out, unlike the military muskets, which have a metal ramrod, his hunting piece has a wooden ramrod. Take a guess which is going to break on a campaign. The wooden. All right, so now he's getting ready. Is this the dry one? All right. You're really loaded? All right, he's really loading his weapon. You'll notice that he's got his nice curly maple hunting weapon ready to go. And he's been trained since he was a child to hit a deer at a good range. In the Revolution, a soldier was expected to fire 4 aimed shots in a minute. So let's see if we can get one off in.
The other militias here, they are fighting various enemies. Indians, various sorts, foreign powers. Now, we're trying